Hey, hello everybody. This is gonna be a ballroom exercise for 30 minutes. So it's really interesting how to work our lower part of our body to our upper part of our body and our head line. So what we're gonna do is understand how we use our ankles, our feet and our ankles, ankles to knees, knees to hips. That's our first exercise today. I'm gonna actually step sideways right now so you can see me. So what I wanna do is I wanna bend my kneecaps. I'm gonna raise to the balls of my feet. I'm gonna rise all the way up. See, I'm getting all the way up, not bent, straighten my legs all the way. I'm gonna bend my kneecaps, lower my ankles, and then I'm gonna straighten my legs again. This works on the ankles and toes, through the knees and through the hips. So we're gonna use all of those four major parts. If you take lessons with me, you understand the hips, the knees, ankles, and toes. Four major parts of the lower part of the body. So we're gonna try this again. We're gonna lower, bend our knees. We're gonna raise our ankles. We're gonna straighten our legs all the way up. Keep that, keep it, hold it. Use your core muscles, right? And then we're gonna bend our knees. We're gonna drop our heels. And we're gonna stand straight up again. So what we're gonna try to do is like an 8-count movement. So let's try it with a 4-count. So we're gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, up. 1, 2, 3, 4, down, 5, 6, 7, 8, down, 1, 2, 3, 4. Perfect, very good. All right, so these are little movements that we wanna work on with the music and understand our lower part of the body. So I'm gonna put some music on, we're gonna try it, okay? So, little music. Okay, here we go, ready? Ready, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. Stand up. 5, 6, 7, 8. Repeat. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Down. 1, 2, 3, 4. Stand up. 5, 6, 7, 8. One more time. 1, 2, 3, 4. Raise up. 5, 6, 7, 8. Up. 1, 2, 3, 4. Down. 5, 6, 7, 8. Down. 1, 2, 3, 4. Stand up. 5, 6, 7, 8. Well done. That's one of the exercises that we're working on today. Okay? So I hope you can help with that. Just use any music. You can use foxtrot music, tango music, as long as we lower through our legs. So if I was standing in front of you, you want to keep your legs, your feet, I'm saying, the length of your shoulders. And then when you drop into your kneecaps, then you can lift your heels. So when you lift your heels, see, I'm still working my core muscles. And then when I stand straight up, I'm still working my core muscles. And when I come down, that's how we want to do it. So if you bend your head, let your head, don't forget our head's the heaviest part of our body. If we send it forward or back, we're going to fall off balance. So we're going to keep that length right through your shoulder width. So we're going to bend our knees, lift our ankles. See how we're lifting our ankles and everything is lined up. And I'm going to stand straight up, nice and tall. I'm going to bend my knees. I'm going to drop my heels. And I'm gonna stand nice and straight up, okay? That's one of the exercises we're gonna do today. Now, the other exercise, like I said, if you work with me, you understand the swing and sway of my body. Now, if you notice when I swing and sway of my body, a lot of the instructors from Viva, we work on this a lot, is using the whole ankle, swinging our legs, swinging our feet, making sure our bodies are moving the lower, there's the pendulum action. We don't wanna do metronome action. If we do metronome action, we're gonna be off balance all the time. There is some movements that we use metronome action, but we wanna use this pendulum action. See how I'm keeping my upper body nice and straight up and down, and I'm losing my lower half of my body, okay? So what we wanna do is keep our legs apart a little bit. We're gonna hold our arms up side. See, I'm almost my feet are a length of where my elbows are at. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna lower through our knees and let our hips swing automatically. Now we're gonna do the same thing to the other side. We're gonna release that ankle. See, I release that ankle. We're gonna put our foot down. Release that ankle all the way. We're gonna release their ankle all the way. So we're gonna swing. So I'm completely over this foot on the inside edge of that foot. Roll all the way through. Roll all the way through. Use those ankles. Get those ankles. You use them to the previous exercise, but we want to use them to this. Now, what we can do with this, we can dance a sidestep, raise up, sidestep, raise up. Just raise up through your knees. If you have bad ankles, that's fine. This is going to strengthen them. We're going to lower, rise up all the way. We're going to take a sidestep, rise up all the way. Using these ankles, stretch, 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 stretch. Using that ankle, stretch, 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 stretch. And let that side swing. Let that side swing. Let that side swing. Much better. So we're going to put a little bit of foxtrot on now. A little bit of foxtrot. Let's get going on this. Here we go. Now there's some little foxy feel. Okay. Here we go. All right. You ready? You ready? Here we go. 5, 6, 7, and a 1. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now we're gonna take a side step. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8. 1, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8. Wonderful. Now, the other things you do with the advanced and students that working on rising, using our bodies, and everything, we can actually go up on our toes on that side step. So when we go in the stove, we can bring this leg in, we're gonna rise up all the way to our toes, lower, pushing that foot back out, rise all the way up to our toes, and lower. That's for the advanced students, okay? Good, perfect. So we worked on the ankles a lot today. We get the ankles down, we're swinging through our bodies, we're rising through our spines, we're keeping all that swing going, okay? So we're gonna try this again, and this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna do it in tango this time. So in tango, we have these sharp movements of our feet, like a promenade link or a promenade open flare. So we're gonna use these into a tap action. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna point our right foot to the side. We're gonna take our right foot, we're gonna step forward on our right foot and point our right foot really strong to the side. Again, we're using that lower half of the body. We're gonna go straight back and point our right foot aside. We're gonna go straight back and point our left foot to the side. We're gonna go forward, point, back, point. Get that power through the legs. Now, notice that I'm using this part of my body to do that, okay? That lower half swinging action. So when I step forward on my left foot and point my right foot to the side, I'm using that left side. So forward, point, back, point, back, point, back, point. Keeping that movement. This is all I talk about with my students, to lowering and using that lower half of our body. All right, so now we're gonna do a double tap, a little bit of more advanced movement. So we're gonna do a step. Side step to the right, we're gonna go step point, we're gonna go forward right foot, step point, and then we're gonna point it. We're gonna do point down, okay? So really get into that legs. And if you notice that I felt off balance there because I pushed my head forward. We wanna still keep ourselves nice and tall. I'm trying to show you little movements that I'm doing. So I'm gonna step forward on my left foot, point my right foot aside, tap, step, step forward. Step, tap, step, okay? So all these little movements that we work on in normal tango movements, not just in silver and gold, but also in bronze, you can get a lot of speed into that stuff, okay? So the other thing is what we were gonna talk about, we're gonna put this to music in tango. We're gonna do step, point is our first one. Step, point is our second one. Back, point, and then back, point. Now we're gonna repeat it. Now we're gonna do the little syncopated side step. We're gonna step, point, step, step. Step, point, step, step, okay? So these are little things that we're gonna try with music to understand how we move our bodies a little bit. So just a minute here, we're gonna take our tango and put some tango music on. And then really, really get into the ankles, really dance those ankles. These little exercises, I talk to my students all the time, and it just helps you to understand and you're disciplined of every step, okay? 5, 6, 7, 8, on 1, 3, 5, 7, and 1. 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now we're gonna do it again, we're gonna do a little snap test. Again, little snap with our right foot. So, 1, step and step, 5, step and step, 5, step and step. Step and step. Okay? So really, really dance that movement when we're dancing. So we're gonna go 1, step and step. Step, step and step. Okay? Really get that tap in. So when we step forward, get that tap. Use those ankles. Okay? Perfect. Very nice. Very well done. Okay? Alright. So we got a few more minutes. What we're gonna talk about. Now, we worked our lower half of the body. Now we're gonna talk about the upper half of our body. Using that energy up here. Now we're gonna stand nice and tall. Keep our feet really further apart. We're gonna take a big, big breath in. Keep our bodies nice and strong, okay? We're gonna rise way up on top. That's it. Keep that stretch, 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 stretch. Lower, 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 lower. Nice, perfect line. Now remember that swing? We're gonna keep our bodies in a nice swinging movement, okay? That's what we're looking for, just like this. Yes, perfect. Now we're gonna take our right arm and bring it all the way into dance position. We're gonna bring our left arm back to dance position, keeping our palms, notice my palm is towards you, and my right palm is towards me. So we're gonna swing our lower half of our body. Draw that in all the way. Take a side step, draw that in all the way. So we're using our lower half, now we're using our upper half to swing. Boom. And swing again. Boom. And swing again. Boom. Very nice. Now, we understand we have balance steps. Forward swing. Back swing. Forward swing. Back swing. Forward swing. Back swing. Side. 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 Very nice. Now you can do these with 8 counts of music. That helps, using through 8 counts. We also be understanding that when we're dancing these movements, I know we talked about the 4 bending parts, hip flexors to knees, knees to ankles, ankles to toes, okay? And again, I can say this all the time that, you know, the students that I work with, we constantly talk about our lower half of our body, okay? We have to make that mobile, okay? So we can move and get our heavy part of our body over the supporting foot. So if I take a side step, my head is over the supporting foot. If I take a back step, my head is over that supporting foot. So all these little things, that's gonna help us to prepare for bronze, silver, and gold movement. Now when you get to gold, anything goes. I mean, you're gonna have a lot more body movements and shapes. But right now, for bronze and silver, we really want to focus on how we can dance like a gold dancer, or from a bronze do look like a silver dancer, or a silver look like a gold dancer. And then gold dancer, of course, looks like a pro out there, okay? So these are build-ups where we're trying to build and how to understand. So the other exercise I have that I talk to my students is the rolling of the arms, okay? So when I'm rolling up my arms, you might be seeing this a lot in different exercises. Rolling these arms right here through backwards, a 4 count, 1, 2, 3, 4, keeping that and then reverse it. 1, 2, 3, 4. So basically it works these shoulder muscles in the back and through your lats, back through here. So understand this, I'm gonna do it from behind you so you can see this. So when I'm rolling it, see I'm rolling my whole, using my whole of my back to dance that. Doing the same way going backwards. These right here, these exercises, again, when you're in dance position, you can really hold your frame and keep your frame nice and strong. Ladies, the same idea. So if you're ladies, you're in position, this is what we're looking for. Nice, strong dance position. So all these upper exercises is gonna help. Now, one of the exercises that you probably can't see is my ribs. When I do with this, it's like, so if I'm pushing my weight down into the floor, pushing into the floor, and then I'm pulling my frame up through my body.
So I'm basically taking my rib, my spine, and sending it back to the back of my body, not like past my rib cage. It's pushing my ribs back so I can put my back of my head over my spine so I can be very, very tall, okay? So I'm very, very strong about this, and I constantly work on it to stand tall while I'm dancing or when I'm walking around the ballroom or going to the mall or walking around your house. It's constantly sending your ribs back to level with your head, okay, the back of your head. So that's what we want to do, back, back, just like this. These are the little strong things that we want to focus on, because then we can still use our lower half that we've been working on so much this next couple days, and also talking about the upper swing of our body. These little things, what we're trying to do is trying to make sure that we're swinging through our body. So the one thing that we can talk about, as I talk to my girls, is a step forward. I'm going to do it sideways so you can see this. So when I step forward on my foot, so you notice that I'm going to step forward on my left foot. When I step on that foot, I'm like almost between the 2 feet, because that's like my easy, like more of a special medium, okay? Now when I lower onto that foot and I get in there, bring my right foot in, it's my complete step, okay? Now I'm going to push off and then do the next step, okay? So I can still have my magic middle of my movement, okay? So these are all things, the exercise you can do. So you step into the foot, okay? Get into that foot, so you're in that magic middle between the ball, the heel of the left foot and the ball of the right foot. So we have that. So again, when we take the next step going backwards or forward, I don't have that much room so you can't really see. But if I'm going to go forward, my magic middle, forward my magic middle. So it's just like we're doing lunges at the gym. So we're gonna do lunges in ballroom. We're gonna go vroom, land in that foot. Then we can take our foot side, like in the waltz, and then draw our foot up. So remember that exercise going side to side, the same idea. So if I did it forward, I'm gonna go forward, side, draw my leg up all the way to the top of my toes, and then lower it back down. Take my leg back, boom. Get over my heel, send my left foot side, draw it all the way back up to the tip of my toes. These are the little things that's going to help us to understand what our bodies do. It's like discipline, using the ankles, your hip flexors, and your upper body. This rib cage, okay? You probably see hear this a lot in rhythm, so when we're pushing your ribs to the side to side. I know a lot of good rhythm dancers out there talk about root movement through the hips and how to use it. But in smooth, we want almost a similar same thing. We want to keep these ribs nice and loose so we can move our body side to side, especially gentlemen, when they're trying to move ladies, and you get different heights, you get different, you know, movements. One person can move bigger than you. Some people can have a little bit more advanced. So you want to make sure your rib cage is really loose. Now, the ladies' job is the hardest, okay? Because first, they're dancing backwards on heels, okay? And the second thing is, they're actually adapting. They're like chameleons to us. So when we change the direction, going into promenade, or going into an open left turn, or changing into an underarm turn from an open right turn, they have to adapt all that swinging action, how we can create power. They're like almost the paint of the canvas, okay? So this is what we have to, girls, we definitely have to adapt. How do we create our hips when we're doing a CBM movement? Making sure our right foot, our right side is moving toward the supporting leg. Same thing going in forward. So my left side is moving toward that supporting leg. Going backwards is the same thing. But notice that my head didn't go wobble all over the place. Some of my students right now are giggling because we talk about that, not to swing their heads all over the place. But, you know, when Rebecca and I are dancing together, we're constantly talking about how we can stand in a position without wobbling. Because if everybody knows Rebecca, she's very, very fast, very, 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 very balanced. So when she's really swinging her head, I have to counterweight that movement. So if we're dancing like in a promenade and an oversway, and so if I'm going an oversway movement and my partner's head's out here, but if my partner's head's here, now it's pushing that weight on me. Again, we're talking about that spine again. So if I'm gonna take my spine into forward, so I'm doing it sideways so you can see it. See, I'm not taking my head back here. All that weight is really bad on your lower come back at the back pain. So we want to send our body forward and keep our leg aligned up there. This is a position that we want to focus on. So to practice that when we're going forward is not sending our head away. We want to send our head forward, put our whole ribs at my shoulder, to my rib, to my hip flexor, to my knee, to my ankle, to my toe, right over each other. Okay, this is where I want to be. Same going on this side. I'm going to repeat it. Same going on this side. I'm going to repeat it. So if I did it sideways, I'm going to go forward over the whole one side. Over one side. There we go. We talk about this all the time, how to swing our bodies. Again, sometimes we get over, like energy and we're trying to move our bodies around. When Eddie and I are at the studio, we're talking about how to swing our bodies. These are the little things that we talk about. How to swing our body up to a position without taking our head weight over the supporting legs. If my head weight, I don't know if you can see this, see if my head weight's over here, my foot, I'm using both my feet just to keep balanced here, okay? But if I send my head weight over my foot, I can stay here all day. So I'm gonna stand right up on that foot. This is where I'm positioned. So, but if I send my head way away, see, it falls over. So these little exercises we're talking about from that shoulders to the rib, to like right where the hip flexor's at. This section right here is very important to understand that this right here is holding this big muscle. I mean, yeah, muscle. This part of our heaviest part of our body in check, okay? So again, if I'm sending my head to the side, see, I can counterweight because I'm not moving my feet or anything. But if I stay here long enough, my body's gonna start rolling to the right side of my body, okay? Because the head weight's going in there, okay? So little exercise with your head. So hope you can see this, okay? So what I wanna do is rotate my head to the left, okay, nice and strong, okay? Rotate my head to the right, really start, really, really get that head over there. Bring my head straight forward, drop my chin to my chest, okay? Take my head all the way back to neutral, sending my head all the way back, look right up to the ceiling, but stretch all this, keep this nice and strong, okay, as far as you can. If you can't go that far, that's fine, but you're stretching all of these muscles right here, okay? And if I don't know these muscles, my wife's gonna hurt me, but that's okay, because she is a physical therapist, all right? So if I turn my head left, I'm gonna keep my chin to my left shoulder, go all the way to the right, my chin to my right shoulder, okay? We'll all be back to neutral, back into my where this called? All right, so, and then we're gonna go all the way back to neutral, back straight up, okay? These are the little things that we wanna focus on in these stretching exercises. Now, the other stretching exercise we wanna talk about is very interesting, is your fingers and your hands, okay? The wrist part of it, the elbow part of it, okay? The other thing is we wanna take our hand and flatten it, and roll our fingers, and roll our finger back. So that means we're using this whole arm. I don't know if you can see that. I'm gonna try to get a little closer. So if I'm gonna roll my fingers and roll my fingers back, roll my fingers and roll my fingers back. Now, if you're just doing this, you're not gonna feel it. But if you really push your hand, like you're gonna push your hand against a piece of glass or a wall, and roll your fingers, and then roll your fingers back. So you're using all of those muscles, all of these muscles in my arm, in my elbow, everything, all of them. You can feel it, all that strength. You wanna do the same thing. This is what you wanna do, the same movements, okay? These little exercises, I mean, these right here are called digits, and some people call them fingers. My wife is saying, wee! Okay, so these little things right here are called digits. So we wanna really roll our fingers, really use those angles. Push our hands out. And then we do the same thing with your ankles. You want to roll these ankles. Understand that. So again, if you don't have that much of balance to stand up on your toes and you're wobbling, get a chair, put your chair down and use your ankles. These are really good exercises. You probably see a ton of different ankle stretches. But these little stretches that we work on, all my students work on this. You can talk to Annette, Jane, Betty Sue, Akiko, all my girls. And Kat, Maggie, all of them, and hello ladies. So all of this right here, these are little things that we want to focus on, how we do certain things. I know some of my students just do rhythm, and they focus on rhythm. So again, we're working on those ankles, getting over that foot. So the same thing, all the little things we talked about. Okay, we have a few minutes left. Okay, so one of the things I want to understand, please be safe out there. God bless you all, okay? And I really want to focus on, I'm hoping you enjoy my session today. I know Rebecca has been trying to get me to get going here, and life has been really crazy around here, but I want you to be safe. I miss you so much. I really can't wait to get to the studio and start dancing again. I know a few of my students are pulling their hairs out, and they really, really, really want to get out there and dancing again, okay? So please, be safe out there. We miss you, and God bless.